Hey there, welcome to Nostalgia Punch, where the past packs a punch. Everybody say hello! My name's James, and what could be more nostalgic than kids' shows we grew up with? Obviously a big part of most people's childhoods, shows aimed towards us kids had the ability to entertain us for hours, teach us life lessons, and even scare the crap out of us. So today me and the Nostalgic Ninja are going to take a look at some we watched and loved growing up.
Are you ready for some hard-hitting nostalgia, Jamie?
I certainly am. Let's get into it. The Trapdoor. Oh, hell yeah. Now, this show was awesome. And if you ask me, it was a bit like a donut, as it was nuts and it was full of dough.
You're not funny.
A simple premise, which opened the door, as in the trapdoor, to some creative ideas.
Truly beautiful. Truly, truly beautiful.
This blue thing called Burke and his spineless pal Boney are tasked with keeping an eye on the trapdoor, which is home to some weird and crazy monsters beneath the castle they live in.
Do you hear something?
Every episode featured some strange thing popping out and causing trouble. It also had one of the catchiest theme songs in a show ever. A short-lived series, but one with long-lasting appeal.
Cause there's something down there.
Woof.
There's a special time in a boy's life when he starts growing hair, can't stop itching, and all he can think about is having a bone. Well, this boy Eric certainly knows what that's like because he turns into a dog.
Charles, we've got a dog in the house.
So we have. Now then, how did you get in?
I said, it's me, Eric. I've turned into a dog.
Based off a book called A Boy Called Wolf, this show decided to shorten its title to just Wolf because kids don't want to read. And over the course of its 8-year run, Wolf entertained us with all sorts of canine escapades. The dogs changed, the cast changed, the budget changed, but overall the charm remained the same.
Come here, you little snake.
Owlbear, the Fifth Musketeer. Everyone can remember the names of the four main musketeers, right? There's D'Artagnan, there's Athos, and there's the other two. But the one I remember the best is Owlbear, the Fifth Musketeer. This little dude had a big personality, always foiling plots to overthrow the King of France, making crazy inventions, fighting off the evil cardinal soldiers. This cartoon had it all.
Let's serve them today's special.
And it just goes to show, it doesn't matter how small you are, you can still leave a big impact.
All for one for all.
Animals of Farthing Wood. Ah yes, a beautiful and charming bit of TV viewing, following the lives and adventures of these wonderful animals, while also showing us how tough and cruel nature can be, through disturbing imagery and violent, horrible deaths. And let us know from an early age that us humans are just a bunch of bastards.
Please.
Don't curl up.
Please.
Whatever you do, dearest, don't curl up.
I don't know why they don't broadcast shows like this anymore. But coming from a 38-year-old man who dresses up like a ninja, it never did me any harm.
Help! That's my wife!
It's just a cartoon, it's just a cartoon, it's just a cartoon, it's just a cartoon.
Dennis the Menace. A cartoon that reminded us all that being a complete bastard could be fun. Based off a popular character from the Beano comics, Dennis the Menace showed us boys that we didn't need school, girls, or baths. All we needed to enjoy life was to insult postmen, run from police officers, and contaminate the town's water supply.
My car! My new car!
And because of this, Dennis has now been seen as a bit of a naughty kid.
Something must be done.
So, Dennis the Menace was rebranded to Dennis and Nasher, because didn't you know you can't use the M word on TV anymore? But seriously, this cartoon was awesome and really, really funny.
Canine Dog Training School, sir, you called?
I did indeed.
Do I take it that this is the problem dog?
So if I was you, I'd check out this naughty 90s version of Dennis instead of this late noughties one we got later.
Ready, Nasher? Let's go!
No, anything but that. Either it's highly overrated. Unstoppable, yeah.
If you want a zombie bunny or a pussycat mummy...
Transylvania Pet Shop. Anyone who's in need of a unique animal should take a trip down to this pet shop, where Dr. Zipbag and his charming assistant, Horror Fido, will have what you're looking for. And if he hasn't got what you want, no problem. A few experiments here and there, and he'll make you what you want.
But what's the matter? Cat got your tongue? Oh, sorry. I have.
Obviously at the right price, of course. They may not always get it right, but it's always fun to watch.
This is an art attack? This is an art attack. This is art attack.
Art attack.
Kids like to be creative, so with the help of Neil Buchanan, we could. Showing us what we can make out of stuff that our mums used to throw in the bin. Then kick off when ours didn't turn out nothing like the shows did. And what made this children's art show stand out above the rest? The head!
Whoa! Hey, cool dude, get on down!
Oh. No, just kidding. It was the big art attacks. Where we used to see lots of small items being put together to make one massive big picture. They were pretty incredible. Maybe it's just the nostalgia talking, but they really don't make them like they used to.
Good joke, eh?
Funhouse. If only all our houses were like this. I don't know what was more incredible, the ball pits, the car wash, or Pat Shop's hairdo. Funhouse was a Friday afternoon must. We saw two teams of two go head to head in multiple challenges in hopes of getting a chance to enter the crazy funhouse and win lots of prizes. These challenges included dressing up like idiots, crazy slow-paced go-kart racing, and gunch. Lots and lots of gunch. Yes, what better way to start the weekend than watching Pat Sharp getting between two twins?
Did you have to say that?
I did. Fair play, Jamie. I'm nostalgia'd out.
Not so fast, Ninja. I got one more.
What? Really?
I wanna be the very best.
Pokemon. If you were a kid in the late 90s, chances are you got sucked into the Pokemon craze. I mean, this crap was insane.
It's the biggest thing from Japan since the Power Rangers.
Starting off with the classic Game Boy games, Pokemon spawned a massive franchise, including toys, clothes, more games, and don't even get me started on those damn Pokemon trading cards. And of course, they had to make a TV show.
Well, money isn't everything, right?
We were glued as we watched the adventures of Ash Ketchum and his buddy Pikachu navigate this crazy world trying to catch as many Pokemon as he could. To love and care for them, and then send them into brutal battles against each other. That's right, us kids couldn't get enough of Ash's seamlessly impossible quest to catch all 150 Pokemon. Eventually I checked out after a couple of seasons, and I'm glad I did, because I've heard now there's like over 1,000 episodes to watch. And roughly over 1,000 Pokemon now. Electro, Diglett, Nidoran, Mankey, Venusaur, Rattata, Firo, Pidgey, Seaking, Jolteon, Dragonite, Gastly, Ponyta,
Vaporeon, Poliwrath, Butterfree! Catch 'em, gotta catch 'em all! This doesn't make sense! Are those stupid things supposed to be animals or robots or what?
I don't know, but I suddenly kinda wanna own them all.
Suppose that proves after 27 years this franchise is as strong as ever. That's why I think Pokemon definitely packs a money-making punch. Well, I think that's enough for today. I think the Nostalgic Ninja's had enough.
I must go now and watch something modern on telly to appreciate nostalgia once more. Ninja, away!
One day might use the door. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.